Yeah, I mean, I'm not gonna, you know, do too much up-to-date stuff with her just because I think she does a pretty good job of keeping you guys posted. You know, everybody has been, I know that she's extremely thankful for everybody that's reached out. We've had tons of flowers, notes, candies, all that kind of stuff sent to the house, and you know, just happy for the support. It's been overwhelming, I know, for her and for me and our whole family. So we really appreciate it. You know, she's tough. She's doing a heck of a job. It's a lot to go through for anybody, especially a, you know, a mother of three and a wife to somebody that's got a high profile job like myself. So she's doing a heck of a job keeping it all together, and had a lot of family and friends support too. Her mom was in town for, you know, over a month, and she was incredible. You know, let me do it what I'm able to do here. You know, let me be back here as she helped, you know, take care of Kelly. And obviously, you know, Tatiana, the lady that helps us with our kids, was incredible too. She's, you know, a part of our family that's irreplaceable. So it's been all hands on deck for quite a while, but it's good for me to get back here with these guys and you know, play some football too.
How tough was that for you?
Excuse me?
Was it tough for you to come back to work? Or?
Yeah, I mean, I don't think anybody sits there and thinks about how they're going to have to handle that situation. You know, I wasn't thinking about it too much. I was really just trying to make sure that my wife was okay. And, you know, like I said, she's tough. She was telling me to get the heck out of the house and go take care of what I need to take care of. And obviously the people here have been incredible. Mrs. Ford has reached out to, you know, myself and Kelly a bunch. Bob and all those guys upstairs have been great and letting me come back kind of at my own pace. And obviously Coach Patricia as well. So I've got an obligation to this team, you know, that I love fulfilling. You know, I want to be here. We've got a new offense. I'm having a blast trying to learn it and teach these guys as well. But at the same time, I had a lot going on at home, and they were really flexible with me and letting me, you know, kind of come in on some off hours and make sure that I was, you know, taking care of my obligation, my, you know, my duty to the team, and then being able to be at home as well.
You get a different perspective on people, Matthew, in a situation like this. In other words, you see a different side of them. It's not just football.
Yeah, with everybody involved, my wife included, you know, I mean, it's everybody. So things like these, situations like this, you know, change your perspective on a lot of things and kind of, you know, put stuff, you know, where it should be. So, but it's been good. Like I said, I'm just happy to be out here throwing the ball around to some really talented guys, having some fun playing some ball.
Matthew, was it almost helpful to immerse yourself in football and get back over
there? It was tough. It was both. You know what I mean? It was some days I was Kelly had a good night. Some days I was here loving it, and you know, Kelly had a bad night. I was trying to get home as fast as I can. So it's been up and down, just as, you know, we kind of expected it to be. But like I said, everybody here has been extremely, you know, extremely supportive, and so my teammates have been great too. So they understand. They know that, you know, I'm committed. I'm dedicated to this team and you know, our future and our season. But at the same time, you know, a lot of those guys have families too and understand, you know, how important that is as well.
How far along are you in this, your assimilation to the new
playbook? You know, I think as far along as I should be. You know. There's obviously a ton more to learn, you know, and a ton more to, you know, the base of the kind of stuff is in there, but you got to be able to play fast, think fast, signal, checks, all that kind of stuff is the second, you know, kind of the second level to it. But I think our guys are doing a great job of diving in. Bev's doing a great job of teaching. Our assistant coaches are doing a great job. So it's on everybody to dive in and make sure that they're ready to go.
How much time a week do you put into, you know, learning the new plays, whether it's here or at home?
What are we allowed to have, CBA? 4 hours here, 6 hours? Something like that. No, a lot of time, especially I think as a quarterback. You know, I got to be the coach in the huddle too. You know, there's questions that come up when you're installing a new offense. We break the huddle. Maybe a guy's got a question or a spot. Hey, am I lined up here, there? What do I have? I've got to be able to be on top of it and communicate it correctly. So I've quite a bit of time.
OTAs in that regard. You know, now you can do a 7-on-7, mm-hmm. 9-on-7.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, I think generally speaking, the more guys you got on the field, whether it's one-on-ones to 7-on-7 to full team periods, you know, the more real football is, the more, you know, your awareness has to be heightened and things are stressed. You know, communication is stressed, alignment is stressed, assignment, all of that kind of stuff. So it's good for us to get out there and, you know, for our guys running routes to run them against the defense, our guys up front to block blitzes and certain protections and all that. So, you know, it's a lot of fun. It's more fun than just throwing routes on air, that's for sure.
Just yeah, Matthew, looks like everything you went through this offseason. I don't know if scary is the right word, but are those scary moments over? I mean, like where are you at now with dealing with everything at home? And where is Kelly at for that matter?
Yeah, I mean, I'm not, like I said, I mean, I'm not going to dive too much into that. I think she does a good job of communicating that. And frankly, I'm not, you know, I don't feel what she feels. You know, I'm not, she can try to explain it to me, but I've never had that done to me. So, you know, I'll let her kind of do that kind of stuff. And as far as,
how about you on a personal level? Are you, you know, I'm sure you had some frightening moments.
Yeah, no question. I mean, there's been some long days and some tough times, but, like I said, ton of help, ton of support, you know, and a strong wife's, helped me out.
It looks like Ragnow's going to play center now. How important is it for you to...
Must know something I don't. What's up?
Well, 1977, he was the guy who was bent over in front
of
him.
Oh, okay.
You know, he talked about it, but, you know, he's played it before in college. But what is, you know, getting the chemistry between the two of you, how important is that as soon as you can?
I honestly think that, you know, this time of year is perfect to... kind of move guys around. You know, I think Graham's had a chance to play center and guard in this league before. Frank's really only had the chance to play guard, obviously played center in college. I think it's important for guys in our system. I think you hear it once or twice before, but being able to position flexibility, you know, being able to play a bunch of different positions and all that is important. So both offensively and defensively, but you know, I think it's good for all those guys to kind of move around on the inside and you know, figure out, you know, down the road where we're playing guys is we'll figure it out.
Can you already tell how different the offense is going to be as far as emphasis and stuff?
You know, emphasis-wise, it's a little bit tough to say at the point, you know, at this point. We're still just kind of putting the basics in. You know, verbiage-wise, sure. I mean, it's completely different, way different. But like I said, I think guys are doing a great job of diving in and trying to, you know, you got to learn what to do so you can go out and compete. You know, those guys that are running around trying to think, it's tough to compete that way. So everybody's doing a great job of trying to learn as much as they can so they can go out there and fly around.
Learning a new scheme, guys often say they try to relate it to something they've done in the past. Just wondering, is there any similarities or overlaps to an offense you've run in the past, whether four pro coordinators or something maybe you did in college?
I think, you know, bits and pieces of a lot of them, you know. But verbiage-wise, it's, you know, a little bit different than most of the stuff I've done. In that regard, I've got to try to forget everything because something maybe in another offense that we called a certain word is means something completely different in this offense. So try to forget the old language and learn a new one. You know, as far as schematically, sure, I feel like I've run quite a few plays over my career and run most of them, I would think. And there's obviously going to be some new wrinkles and some things that Bevel, you know, brings to us. But at the same time, we're just going out there trying to execute, you know, whatever he gives us.
Yeah, a lot of eyes on T.J. Hawkinson. What have you seen from him? So if we cut a couple today, look pretty good. What
yeah. You know, I think he's doing a good job, you know, moving around out there, caught some balls, like he said. I think he'd probably be the first guy to tell you he feels like a rookie. Rookies, you know, it's a lot of action going on out there. You know, they've got a new, you know, system to learn, new city to learn, new coaches, players, all that. I mean, there's a lot going on. Just try to do everything we can to help those guys. At some point in the year, we're going to need all those guys. And, you know, I know they know that. We just try to push them along as veteran kind of leaders of the team and make sure that they're, you know, in position mentally and physically to help us.
To go along with that, no Marv, no Kenny in the team stuff at the very least, what sort of opportunity is that for the young guys, you to get on the same page with the young guys, give them some reps?
Yeah, I think it's really good for those guys, you know, to come in and get opportunities. Some of those guys I played some late, you know, late last year with, obviously, you know, Danny haven't played any games with him, so it's been nice to get out there and throw the ball around to him a little bit, mixing a bunch of tight ends, backs. This time of year is so much more, you know, let's learn the fundamentals of this offense. Let's get back to the fundamentals of the game. You know, it's such a basic part of the year that, you know, it's really good for everybody to just get opportunities to go out there and kind of play ball.
As Kelly gets better and stuff, do you operate with a clear head or do you still – they have flash or think of what's going on all the time when you're out here? How hard is that?
I think when I'm here, you know. You know, there's maybe some time before practice in the locker room or something, just checking in, making sure everything's okay. But when I'm out here, man, I gotta be locked in. I feel like, you know, a lot of practice at my position, being able to, you know, kind of compartmentalize what's going on. And if I'm out here thinking about something else, it's going to be an ugly day for the offense. So I'm trying to do everything I can to be locked in. And to be honest with you, having a new playbook to learn is kind of helping. You know, I'm just sitting there going, man, I got it's not old hat. You know, it's a bunch of new stuff. It's the stuff I got to really dive deep into and you know, try to make sure that I'm on top of my game, because I'm getting questions right and left from those guys, and I'm trying to help them out as much as I can. So, not to say that I'm forgetting everything that's going on back home, but I for sure am locked in when I'm here.
And Matt, how difficult was last season, and I guess what kind of momentum or motivation does that provide for this season?
I think every season's a challenge. Obviously, we didn't win as many games as we wanted to last year. To a man, probably didn't play as good as we could, myself included, no question. But I'm motivated every year I come in, whether it's, you know, by the past or really just looking forward to the future. You know, I want to go out there and win games. I want to play as good as I can possibly play. And if I play, you know, really well, it's going to help our team have a chance to win. So that's what it's all about at this point. And I'm just trying to do everything I can.
It's kind of deep, but do you have a new approach to new approach to life, you know, with everything that's going on here the last few months?
I don't know. Probably a little early to say that. But, no, like I said earlier, I mean, I think it just puts a lot of stuff in perspective for me. You know, I still love, you know, coming out here and playing ball.
Was there ever a point where you thought you might have to step away for a little bit? Did you ever reach that point?
You know, I took a little bit of time at the beginning, but I was ready to do whatever I needed to do to help her. And she's as tough as they come and did such a great job that, you know, luckily I was able to get back here at somewhat of a timely manner. And like I said, the support we had from, you know, family and friends is what really made it possible. You know, I couldn't have left her home, you know, alone for that long, and obviously people were there to help her and you know, allowed me to come out here and at least get some time in with my teammates and make me feel somewhat up to speed when we got out here throwing it around.
Just to be clear, you never thought 2019, like, the season was in jeopardy, right? Like, was that ever
I tell you the truth, it wasn't even on my mind. You know, when she was in surgery a few days out, I wasn't thinking about anything, but
what's it like being at center now? That's kind of surprising to us. What is it for you?
Oh, it's good. You know, I've obviously played the position in college, and I know this is going to sound boring, but I mean, you play what you can play. I think it adds value to you as a person the more you can do, and I'm just trying to fit my role, whatever role they pick me to choose.
How different is it going? You know, was it going from center to left guard, or now from left guard to center?
Well, I think the transition to left guard was a little more difficult because I haven't played it before, and center I have played before, so there's definitely some experience there. So I'd say it's, I guess, a little smoother, but there's definitely those bumps and bruises along the way for sure.
And what about making calls and all that from stuff like that, and sort of being like the captain in the middle?
I enjoy that part of the game. That was a part of the game I really enjoyed in college, making all the calls, kind of leading the guys. But like I've said before, I mean, this offensive line room is so unique that there's, I mean, it's like there's five centers up front. Everybody's talking, everybody's communicating, so it's great.
So last year you come in, you have to learn the first year of the Lions offense, and now you come in Bevel's here, and how different are things, and how much more of a learning curve is it again for you?
Things are definitely different verbiage-wise and everything, but I mean, a lot of the things are similar. You're just using different words, and you just got to find ways to relate it and connect it and kind of put it all together.
In terms of footwork and all that, from what you did in at center and at Arkansas here, is that pretty much a lot of that stuff the same in terms of balance and leverage?
Yeah, very similar. At Arkansas, I was blessed to play in a pro-style offense, and it's transitioned pretty well here. Yeah. So that footwork-wise, it's not much of a crazy change.
When were you aware that this was going to happen? Is this...
We've kind of cross-trained my whole time here. So, I mean, it's just kind of whatever they're telling me to go, I'm going to go, and I'm going to try to do it to my best of my ability. So it's kind of been throughout the spring. We've been moving around and everything.
You know, there's always moving pieces, coaches, players, and whatnot, but one more year under Matt Patricia, how much more do people kind of know what to expect coming in and the work that you need to put in and familiarity with that type of coaching and whatnot and system?
Yeah, I think anywhere you go, anything you do, the more comfortable are you with someone, the more you know someone, the better everything's going to mesh. And I think we were definitely learning this culture. I'm not gonna say anything about this year, but I mean, we're working hard, and everybody's starting to work hard. And day to day, we're coming in and we're training, and that's kind of the culture I think Coach Patricia's really trying to build. Is just one day at a time, hard work, and that'll get you where you want to be.
Do you notice any changes in him or his demeanor, or just the way he approaches things this year? Maybe being a little more comfortable in his.
I'm not a rookie anymore, so I don't have to deal with the rookie treatment. But otherwise, he's the same guy, and I respect that about him. He's consistent every single day.
If this offense is more ground and pound like you sort of think it is with Darrell Bevel, is that something you would embrace?
Yeah, I think up front, as an offensive lineman, most offensive linemen would say they really enjoy the running part of the ball, run blocking and everything. But like I said, whatever we need to do to win, I think of all five of us up front are going to do that to win.
Just a couple more guys.
Yeah, what is the biggest difference for you in this this year's camp as opposed to last year? In other words, comfort level, whatever it is.
Oh, just the more you play at this any level, the more you do something, the game slows down. And I've definitely noticed that just these two OTAs, it slowed down for you. That rookie year is quite the whirlwind. When you're going from this, there, that, you never really get to catch your breath. So this offseason was good for me to get in the weight room and get working, but also to just catch my breath and kind of realize, all right, I'm here, and now let's get to work.
Yeah. What was it like to have TJ Lang out here yesterday, not in pads, not working with you guys? And is he kind of someone who can give advice to you now, specifically with right guard, now that that's kind of an area you're getting a little bit of work in?
TJ definitely is just such a great resource, and he made sure before he retired, he reached out to all of us and made sure to let us know that he's here no matter what, and it's great to have him around, and whatever he can offer, I'll take, because he's done it at this level at a high level.
Have you put on any muscle mass or weight over the season?
You know, I don't know the specifics. Does it look like it?
A little bit.
Thank you. Thank you.
Short sleeves.
Yeah. I don't know the specifics, but I mean, I've been working hard, so
yeah, okay.
Hopefully, yeah.
So that was that your aim, though?
Definitely every offseason, trying to get leaner and leaner you can.
You guys have been in the building for a little bit already. Mm-hmm. What is it like getting out here on the field? How does it change things?
Well, it's great. It's football now. I mean, you got with all the rules and everything, you've got so much you can do, but it's good to get out here and play football. That's what we're here for.
Frank, it's another year under Matt.
Last one, guys.
He's incredible, man. I mean, you really can't describe the guy. He's just a great leader for all of us. Everybody looks up to him. He's an incredible person. I remember watching him as a kid, and now I'm playing with him. He's an incredible leader.
Everybody's a competitor. Everybody's out here to get better, perfect their craft, and I just love being a part of this system right now.
The fact that you can play inside, outside, move around, obviously Bob and Matt talked about that after drafting you. Are you seeing that initially? Is that a fun part about being in this defense too? Is there's multiple roles, multiple things you can do within it?
Well, first I got to learn the playbook. I got to perfect that part. But other than that, I'm taking day by day, and wherever the coaches need me, that's where I'll be. I'm just one of the puzzle pieces to our organization. So. Like I said, I'm just trying to take it day by day.
How do you go about learning the playbook? What's maybe your process?
Just talking to the vets. The vets learned it last year, and they're doing a great job for the younger guys. But I just got to take the responsibility to learn it on my own and just do the right thing.
Jahlani, did you read any of the coverage about your draft pick or read
anything? No, I don't really care, worry about anything. I think there was a quote, Lions don't listen to to the opinions of goats or whatever. So I'm just going to have that mindset and just focus on what I can control. And right now I can just control taking care of my body and just worrying about tomorrow now.
I was just curious because fans obviously didn't kind of know who you were. I don't know if there was some sense of I'm going to silence any doubt or these people wrong.
I mean, it's hard if you're from Hawaii, but, I'm just, like I said, I'm just trying to take day by day and learn this defense and just help the team out.
What's the transition been like for you, having come from Hawaii, where you were a leader, a guy who took people under his wing and helped out, I think coached some kids or whatever, some local kids there, and now you're a student and you're a young guy, and how's that transition going from leader to student?
I mean, it's been great getting to learn from the guys who are vets here. They're great leaders, and I strive to try and become a leader like them. So, like I said, if I just take day by day, then hopefully I'll get to that point, but... We just gotta worry about the next day. So, yeah.
Does it feel alien to you to be here?
Oh, not at all. This is a great environment. I love how the coaches have a standard on just being successful. So, I want to engrave that in my mindset and just come out here every day and just be a Lion.
How have guys like JD, Christian, kind of taking under the wings? I think you're stepping into a good situation there with guys who've kind of...
I think the whole organization does a great thing, a great job about it. But again, you just got to take responsibility on your own and just know that it's a new environment, and you just got to learn on the go.
Have your brothers, they've had a taste of pro ball. Have they helped you at all with transitioning to the pro game?
I mean, they gave me tips and details, but everybody's experience is different. So, I mean, my main message right now is literally take it day by day. And I've been doing that for a while. So,
what do you think of this weather?
Oh, this is great. great.
See too much of this up there, right?
I mean, not really. But I'm just grateful to be here. I'm grateful for the opportunity that Mrs. Ford, Bob Quinn, and Coach Patricia have given me. So I'm just going to make the most of it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
They lit the fires under our feet, chased us into the hills. Oh, they let the wolves off of the leash. Should have finished the kill. We got ashes on our shoes and an outcast attitude. And we're all immune, cause we know the truth is viral. We might be the outsiders, but the in crowd is so loud right now. And we might be the outsiders, but the in crowd is so loud right now. On the fringe, with our backs to the cool now, and in our heads we fit right in, cause they gave us the fuel. We got ashes on our shoes and an outcast attitude. Yeah, we're all immune, cause you know the truth is viral. So out right now.